स्टडी कलर ब्लाइंडनेस. व्हाट इज कलर ब्लाइंडनेस? कलर ब्लाइंडनेस इट इज अ डिसऑर्डर कॉज ड्यू टू एक्स लिंक्ड रिसेसिव जीन. नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय एक्स लिंक्ड जीन? द जीन्स विच आर प्रेजेंट ऑन नॉन होमोलोगस पार्ट ऑफ एक्स क्रोमोसोम. एंड व्हाट इज रिसेसिव? द कैरेक्टर विच इज नॉट एक्सप्रेस. ओके, दैट कैरेक्टर इज कॉल्ड एज रिसेसिव कैरेक्टर. दिस कैरेक्टर इज डिटरमाइंड बाय रिसेसिव जीन. सो कलर ब्लाइंडनेस इट इज ड्यू टू एक्स लिंक्ड रिसेसिव जीन. दिस इज फर्स्ट पॉइंट. सेकेंड पॉइंट, द पर्सन हु इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम कलर ब्लाइंडनेस इट इज अ डिसऑर्डर. ओके, सो द पर्सन हु इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम कलर ब्लाइंडनेस इज नॉट एबल टू डिस्टिंग्विश टू कलर्स. नाउ विच आर द टू कलर्स? रेड एंड ग्रीन कलर्स. बोथ द कलर अपीयर्स ग्रे फॉर दैट पर्सन. नाउ इन दिस पर्सन स्पेसिफिकली द कोन सेल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द रेटिना ऑफ द आई दे आर नॉट डेवलप. कोन सेल्स दे आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द परसेप्शन ऑफ द कलर. बट इन दोज पर्सन दिस कोन सेल्स आर नॉट फॉर्म एंड दैट्स वाई कलर ब्लाइंडनेस इज फॉर्म. ओके, नाउ दिस इज द टेबल, शॉर्ट और अ स्मॉल टेबल वेर यू हैव टू रिमेंबर when you solve the examples. The question may come, what is color blindness, and write the inheritance of color blindness. For that you will have to remember, no need to write this table, just you will have to remember this chart. You have to write the description of color blindness and you are going to write this inheritance. Okay, now I'm going to repeat this because already we have studied this. This here I have written sex, male and female, normal male. Before that, here normal vision we are using capital C, and for color blind vision we are using small c, and I have shown with red color. Okay, so here male, if they are normal, XY, these are the sex chromosomes, and capital C. Why capital C? Because males are normal. If males are colorblind, here I have written XY and small c with red color. It indicates that male is colorblind. Females are normal. Here XX sex chromosomes, for every block I have written XXXX. Here XX capital C capital C. It indicates normal vision. Here females, if they are colorblind, both the X chromosome, they have small c, which indicate that female is colorblindness, having colorblind. And here, if females are carrier, XX, okay, on one X, capital C, on one X, small c, which indicate that female is a carrier female. Now, how you are going to describe the question? Write the inheritance of color blindness. Okay, from one generation to another generation. Let us study. If color blind male marries a woman, normal woman or normal female, these are the parents. What are the genotype of their parent? Color blind male, see here it becomes very easy if you keep the chart. Color blind male means X C Y. Normal female XCXE here. Okay, just you will remember the chart. So the example or inheritance, it becomes easy. Now these are the genotype, but what are the gametes? During gamete formation, these gametes get separate, meiosis. Gametes, this XC and Y get separate, XC and XE get separate. Okay, now these are the sperms and these are the eggs. Okay, these are the gametes. Now we are going to study the possibilities. Take only this sperm and you will fertilize this sperm with this egg and this egg. Okay, so XC and XE, here I have written correct? Now XC and XC, okay? So this combination is over. Now you have to take this. This you will cross with this first, and then this you are going to cross with this. So in this manner, you are getting first XCY and then you are getting XCY. Now let us see what is this. When one is capital C, one is small c, one is capital, one is small. It means these are, no doubt, the sex chromosomes are XXXX. Means these are the daughters only. But they are carrier daughters. Carrier means they are carrying that colorblind gene. Now, the characteristic of carrier daughter is they are having normal vision. Only the thing is that they carry that gene in their body and they transfer the gene in the next generation. Okay, so 50% carrier daughter, and these are the XY, XY means son, but capital C is there. It means 50% normal son. In the first generation, F1, F stands for filial. F1 generation, there is no color blind daughter or the son. But this is first generation. In second generation, if these carrier daughter, if marries with a normal male, are you getting? If carrier daughter marries with normal male, what are the genotypes? X capital C, X small c, X capital C, Y. These are the gametes. They get separate. Okay. In F2 generation, filial generation, take this first and cross with this first. Take this and cross with this. Now again, take this, you cross with this, take this and cross with this. In this manner, you are getting, see, XX means daughter, capital C means normal. Here, XY means son, capital C means normal. Here, XX means daughter or female. Here, one is capital, one is small means carrier. And in the last, if you see, XY small c. Now, this XY having small c is a colorblind male. It means this colorblind male gene is getting, means this male or son, you can say, is getting from her mother. And this mother is getting that gene from his or her father. Okay. Now, this transmission of the gene or inheritance of this character from father to daughter and from daughter to son. Okay. Now, this male become grandson. Okay. This grandson is getting that gene from the grandfather. Such type of inheritance is called as criss-cross inheritance. What it is called as? Criss-cross inheritance. The question may come, define colorblindness and explain criss-cross inheritance. So, you will able to write this answer in this manner. We will study hemophilia. What is hemophilia? Hemophilia is a disorder due to X-linked recessive gene. We have studied colorblindness. Colorblindness, it is also due to X-linked recessive gene. So this is second example of X-linked recessive gene. Okay. Second point, the person who is suffering from hemophilia, in those persons, clotting of the blood, it takes time. Okay. In healthy person, suppose the person is having injury and blood start flowing. In healthy person, that blood, it stop after some time, flowing of blood, it stop after some time. But the person who is suffering from hemophilia, द क्लॉटिंग टाइम इट टेक्स अ लॉन्ग टाइम और ब्लड डजंट स्टॉप. सो दिस डिसीज इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ब्लीडर्स डिसीज. ओके एंड द कॉज इज इट इज ड्यू टू द डिफेक्टिव जीन प्रेजेंट और नॉन होमोलोगस पार्ट ऑफ एक्स क्रोमोसोम. ओके हियर वी हैव इंडिकेटेड सपोज हेल्दी पर्सन जीन वी इंडिकेटेड बाय कैपिटल एच. वाई वी आर यूजिंग दिस एच लेटर ओनली. एच स्टैंड फॉर हीमोफीलिया. ओके एंड द डिफेक्टिव जीन बाय स्मॉल लेटर. सो कैपिटल एच इंडिकेट नॉर्मल क्लॉटिंग टाइम एंड स्मॉल एच इट इंडिकेट द हीमोफिलिक जीन. ओके सो दिस इज द चार्ट. दिस चार्ट यू आर गोइंग टू रिमेंबर. द क्वेश्चन मे कम वॉट इज हीमोफीलिया. ओके द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन कम डिस्क्राइब द इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ हीमोफीलिया. वन मोर थिंग द क्लॉटिंग फैक्टर्स इन केस ऑफ हीमोफीलिया एंड स्पेसिफिकली द क्लॉटिंग फैक्टर लाइक 8 or 9 दे आर एब्सेंट इन द पर्सन हु सफर फ्रॉम हीमोफीलिया. द क्लॉटिंग फैक्टर प्लेज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन द क्लॉटिंग ऑफ द ब्लड बट इफ दिस फैक्टर्स आर एब्सेंट definitely the blood clotting time it delays. Okay now let us see. Here I have written male and female sex. Normal male having this type of genotype X capital H which indicate normal clotting time. Okay XY here XY here I have written small h indicate hemophilia. Males are not carrier because that gene is present only on X chromosome. Y chromosome, the gene is not present. Female, if they are normal, they have X capital H, X capital H, right? If females are hemophilic, X small h. And if females are carrier, X capital H, X small h. Means, if females are hemophilic, they should have 2 doses of this hemophilic gene. Okay. But for male, 1 gene is also sufficient. If females are carrier, means what? 1 dominant gene is present, 1 recessive gene is present. Okay. In presence of dominant gene, the recessive gene gets suppressed. It cannot express. Okay. Now, this is the inheritance. This is first generation. This is second generation. Let us study. Hemophilic male, if marries with normal female, these are the parents and these are the genotypes. Okay, what are the genotypes? X, small h, y, XX, at the top I have written capital H, which indicate she is having normal clotting period. Okay, she is not having that disease. These are the gametes. Gametes get separate. So here, X small h, Y, X capital H, X capital H. During meiosis, the gametes get separate. Okay. So here, first generation. Now, if you consider, these are the sperms and these are the eggs. Right. This sperm, if fertilized with this egg, the combination will be X capital H, X small h. If this sperm fertilizes this egg, X capital H, X small h. Okay. So, here both the, the offsprings are the daughters. But these daughters are carrier because they are carrying single gene. Correct. Now, take this sperm. If this sperm fertilizes this egg, this combination. If this sperm fertilizes this egg, this combination. This combination means XY means they are son. But they are having capital H means they are normal son. 50% carrier daughter, 50% normal son. In the first generation, hemophilic gene is transferred. But that female is not sufferer. If this carrier daughters in second generation marries with a normal male, these are the parents, these are the genotypes. Here 2X means it indicate female, XX capital H small h indicate carrier daughter. Normal male means having capital H. These are the gametes. They get separate. X capital H, X small h, X capital H and Y. And these are the possibilities in F2 generation, filial generation. If you take this and you have to cross this with first this and then this. So you are getting these two combination. Take this and you have to cross with this first and then with this. So in this manner, you are getting female and male. But this female is normal. This male is also normal. 25%, 25%. Here 2X means again female. But that female is carrier because she is carrying one capital H, one small h. Small h indicates the gene which is there for hemophilia. And here we are getting hemophilic male or hemophilic son because X small h and Y. It indicates that if you see the inheritance, we started with hemophilic male, correct? This gene, it comes in the daughter. When this daughter marries with normal male, that defective gene, it comes in her son. Means, this grandson, it get that defective gene from grandfather. Okay? Male to female, from female to male. Such type of inheritance is called as criss-cross inheritance. Criss-cross inheritance. So, in this manner, you can explain.